But it does not stop. Mm. We have Fujimura versus Echo Fox's Justin Wong coming up next. One of our last remaining hope on the side of the United States.
All right, well, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage Echo Fox's very own Justin Wong.
And that man has done some travel this year. I saw his schedule and I was like, man, you know he's done the work, the homework, the legwork, the travel work to be on this stage right now. Especially to make it to a top eight.
Man, I see him coming down those stairs. I just think about that match where he was in the EG and he was doing all the peace signs to everybody.
Right, he was doing the peace signs.
I got like the throwback right there. Justin Wong, winner's side, top eight.
Now, we talked about one of the major threats here, and that's going to be Justin Wong's opponent.
Yes. Please welcome to the stage, everybody, Fujimura. Man, he is just so cool, calm, and collected. That's the thing about him is that he's one of those players that always makes the right choice, right? It's very rare that you see him have big mistakes or big drops or anything like that in clutch moments. He always makes the proper choice. He uses his resources extremely well on a very resource-intensive character.
Oh, yeah, most definitely. I mean, we talked about, look, I call this dude the Juice Man. Mm-hmm. He squeezes every ounce of damage and situational power out of every setup, out of every combo. That's who Fujimura is. And he's been doing it consecutively and successfully all year. That's one of the reasons he's here, and a lot of people picked him, including you, to take this entire tournament.
Yeah, and when you look at, like, you know, you open up the Twitter, you look at hi-fi clips, and you see Fujimura, and you're like, his opponent has 80% life. There's no way this Shuriken setup's going to kill. And then all of a sudden, you're like, wait a minute.
What? Huh?
He does, like, kunai. He throws all the kunai command dash in the air, the heavy punch. He does, like, a super after, and then, like, the hand signs come out. You're like, wait, I thought he was, oh. And then it's just like, all right, we'll lose his bracket for his opponent. Fujimura moves on. Like, he's just that good in those moments. And it's very rare to find a player who plays like a resource-intensive character like this that just always does the right thing. It's very easy to make mistakes and be like, oh, well, in this situation, he could have spent this to do that, or maybe saved an EX bar here, but he like makes the right choice every time.
Now, you speak about somebody making the right choice and taking their time. Justin Wong is the other side of that. Like, he doesn't go too crazy intensive on the combos, but when it comes to controlling the pace of a match, getting the damage that counts, and keeping life close enough to close out, get those mix-ups, it's none other than Justin Wong.
Yeah, I mean, average round time is 77 seconds, right? The longest round time average for Justin Wong. Imagine a Street Fighter match, 99 seconds on the clock, and he uses up every second he gets. We call him Father Time. For a reason, right? He's that player that you can always expect to play the clock, and he is a masterclass at playing defensive, right? He is absolutely ridiculous at this playstyle, and it's extremely impressive how you think about this game, you think about, you know, high damage, high stun, crush counters everywhere, you know, a fast-paced explosive match. Mm-hmm. Justin Wong can control the craziness, and he can sit there and make you play on the ground with him.
Oh, most definitely, and it doesn't matter what character it is, and that's gonna be the main crux of this matchup. Fujimura plays a character that's always going to be there. You talked about those kunais. It's also the mobility. Mm-hmm. If she gets triggered, that's in a completely different thing of its own. But here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Make some noise for Justin Wong. Make some noise for Fujimura. This is our last hope. Let's go.
My last hope is Fujimura, Steve.
Right? Exactly. I said R. I was talking about the people in the crowd. Say, damn, not you. Obviously, you're a traitor. Fight. Let's go.
I'm no traitor. My loyalty is some good old-fashioned Street Fighter. Okay. As the V-skill connects, that's going to be an important thing about this matchup, actually. So when Justin's trying to land those crouching jabs, if he reads the V-skill, he can use the stand heavy punch to make it reach, but it can be tough. Mm-hmm. A little punish on the sweep, and this is how it's going to be. Just this grind of a match. Fujimura trying to constantly move in with the kunai. Justin with the snipes on all the approach options.
And look, he's letting him get these kunai back. And he's like, it's cool. This is what I was talking about. I'm going to hit you no matter what.
Yeah.
So you can have all the resources in the world. It won't matter if you don't get to use them.
Yeah, and Justin Wong, he's the style of Manat. He plays from, you know, the three-point line. He plays from half court, right? He's just sitting way back there waiting for this. But this is the big opportunity. Side switch mix-up. Justin gets clipped looking for the cross-up.
All right, that's really not that bad. But that is pretty bad. Gets the crush counter on follow-up. Takes him from wall to wall. Gets the corner as well. Goes for the neutral jump. And this is where the patient kicks in.
Oh, wow, he got a kunai reload. Probably not what he intended in Justin. He's very safe, very sound with these orbs, right? Nothing crazy on the mix-ups. Wow, try to get the punish with a reversal EX Ryder. Orb release in the air, yo.
Oh, what a conversion. Justin Wong gets the jump in, still has two orb left. There's a forward throw, sends out all the orbs and the explosion. Justin! And this is what I was looking at. 28 seconds left on the clock. Yep. That is father time at its finest.
But Mr. Sandman himself waits everything out slow.
Oh, nice jump in. Gets the EX Kunai just to follow up the same situation.
This is where it gets bad, right? This Kunai spaced so well. Fujimura's in early. We'll see how Justin's defense holds up in this set.
Oh,
he tried to bait the throw.
So perfect. Oh, no, hitting the button a little too early, but it commits. And that's the wrong thing to do, a scramble here in the middle of the screen. Another jump in by Fujimura. This could be the round on the next mix-up. There's the throw. Fujimura answers back instantly. And 71 seconds left on the clock. That's what I was talking about, that back and forth, the pace control. Justin versus Fujimura is like the Flash versus time, dude. It's like super fast versus super slow.
Yeah, that's the difference between these two players, right? Fujimura is going to be that player that gets in, makes the wild mix-ups happen, that crouching medium kick. Not the worst thing that Justin could have been hit by, but yeah, you notice Fujimura going to the air approach a lot now.
Oh, yeah.
And Justin's got to start to scout that. Once he does, Fujimura's going to start dashing in just like that, but Justin with the check.
He talked about taking to the air. Justin has been pretty consecutive with his anti-airs as well, starting off with that crouching hard.
Oh, boy.
Right now, getting throw looped in the corner. The shuriken.
Cross up to the other side. Justin's defense, very solid. This round is looking like it's Justin's favor as he's got V-Trigger live to work with. Orb release. Yeah, he tried to answer here with it. Mix-ups.
Gets the four throw steal. Three orbs left. Sets him out from the top of the drill.
And look at this. He's just got to walk and block Fujimura without a V-Trigger.
Has to be
tried the throw, and Justin Wong with game one.
Look, man, everybody knows the lore of ninjas. They move fast, silently, in the dark, sometimes under a shuriken. You never know. Justin's like, look, I don't care about any of that. You're going to go
you
at
know
my
how much
pace.
Anime Justin watches?
Look, trust me. We've watched anime together. I know he's an aficionado. He knows how to deal with ninjas. There's many anime about it out there. All right, here we go. Game two.
Looking for that air approach. And that's the thing. Fujimura, when the air approach doesn't work, he's going to have to dash in on the ground. He's going to have to use the V-skill. And Justin's going to have to try to constantly be ready for, you know, the switch up of approach, right? Dash up sweep. Next time you got to look for like jump kunai, right? Next time you got to look for the see, it's just going to switch up these options constantly.
And now it's become a process of switching back and forth between all of them. Gets the V trigger.
Yeah, raw shuriken 50-50 in the corner overhead. One more for the dizzy. Another 50-50 here. Back throw. Fujimura clinical as ever. That's the round.
The juice man. I want all the damage. I'm going to use all my kunai and all the meter if I had to, but I want that damage.
Clinical round for Fujimura. The back throw for the dizzy. Perfect choice. We'll see how Justin deals with the approach again.
Jump back. I like the attempt on the air to air. I'm loving the play right now from Justin. This is definitely the best Street Fighter I've seen him play in years.
Yeah, he's just playing this kind of slow and steady, very solid game plan, and you can see how far it's taking him. Back to basics, right?
Look, just buttons. There we go. You talked about coming in from the air, but she definitely has buttons that can stop that approach as well. But this ground approach opening up after that. Three throws in the row.
The release. Shuriken, 50-50 instant overhead or low.
That's going to work.
Justin Wong with the reversal.
Those hips don't lie. He's still alive, though.
Uh-oh, he's got super as well. Fujimura sitting on it. You got to watch. Got to be very careful. He has EX bar. He's so patient. He's going to wait forever.
Right?
No risk the throw. He walked all the way in.
Very obvious what Justin wants to do. He wants to successfully lame you out. That's
Look at that. Jump back, heavy kick, the standing fierce after these normals are adding up. Fujimura's getting impatient.
I mean, I can see why. You can tell that Justin has no problem playing the defensive side of it. You can see that he has the chops to do so. He's gotten out of a few situations. Uh-oh, not this jump in, though. Now Fujimura has a chance. Spins the EX bar.
50-50, throw will stun.
Oh, once again, the exact same situation we saw from the first round here.
Release. EX, not enough to kill. And the throw will do it. Fujimura. That's as clinical of a round as he can ask for, right?
Oh, yeah.
He sees that back throw will stun. He repositions back in the corner. Gets as much damage as possible, 50-50 out.
And he he is pressing those situations quite well, if I do say so myself. Keeping that corner positioning in his favor, and you can see now a lot less kunai action going on. Well, not on the ground anyway. He likes to take that air approach with the kunai just to make sure, just to check to see if Justin's ready for that ground approach.
Yeah, and if you notice the difference between when these two wins rounds, right? Like Fujimura, it's like, wow, he got a hit in the corner and Justin just guessed wrong. And then when Justin wins, it's 99 seconds of just him keeping you out. But Fujimura, look at this round go. Right up for the kill.
Ouch. 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 And that's the pace that I'm talking about.
Yep.
The slower this round goes, the better it looks for Justin. But if Ibuki can get in, it is a completely different ball game.
Yep, so that's what Justin has to constantly do, right? Try to figure out the timing on when Fujimura is going to get in and try to survive on defense.
Oh yeah, most definitely. And now you see the guess. Like I said before, cycling between those options of getting in the air and on the ground, Fujimura finds a way in. Another throw. He's found so much success.
Oh. The jump in, cross up, close to Dizzy. Snipe out of the air.
Mm-hmm, so good. Using the V-trigger, has the orbs as well. This isn't over. Blocks the EX Rider, but not a solid punish. Justin.
Yeah, a missed opportunity there. He at least created some space for himself. All right, Fuma Shuriken comes out. Little check from Justin. The hit, but he didn't confirm.
Still has trigger. Oh, gets hit with two. No more orbs left.
Yeah, Justin's got space and he's got meter. The two things that Minot needs to close out the round.
Mm-hmm. On top of that, he has full CA. This is good news for Justin. He has the tools. Just no trigger on back of it, but he has to be careful. Reloading. Shuriken
has most of the kunai's back now, which is good. She can just kind of sit there and play this long range game. You gotta watch Justin though, full critical art.
You gotta be careful throwing out those shurikens because you commit a little too hard.
We'll punish. Ooh, a little bit on the rider.
25 seconds left on the clock, Justin.
You know Justin's not the kind of guy to get antsy usually though. He's pretty good about playing the clock even if he's at a deficit.
How does this affect Fujimura? Does he take his time, gets the air to air?
A trade, 14 seconds left. Justin slowly trying to move in, but 10 seconds.
It hits that 5 second mark, and I was about to say.
Yeah, critical art can't be a use anymore. He's got to find it, but the anti-air. A little taste of his own medicine as Fujimura plays the slow game.
Like I said before, cycling through those options, going with the air kunai, and sometimes just staying on the ground to check Justin, getting those throws to get him knocked down in the corner, has definitely flushed out his gameplay, gave him that second game pretty confidently, and now you see Justin thinking. He's going back to character select, and I don't blame him.
Yeah, just take some time to sit here and think about maybe some of the adjustments. Obviously, Fujimura is doing a good job of making the air approach, right? Because he's so, like, insistent on it. He won't stop jumping, whether it's kunai or jump normal. And I think Justin had a couple of times where he like did a button and then like Fujimura just jumped over it clean. So maybe he has to make that extra little adjustment about looking for the air a bit more.
Oh, that's definitely true. It always seems like he goes for one ground approach and then he jumps. And Justin hasn't been prepared the last 3-4 times he's done that.
Mm-hmm. And there's just so many ways to change your air options, right? Like, you know, her jump arc is already a little tricky to deal with because it's kind of like a floaty jump.
Yeah.
But she also has kunai out of it, right? Or she has command jump. So there's just so many different ways this character can get in.
All right, here we go. This is winner's side, ladies and gentlemen. Set count 2-1 on the side, Fujimura.
We'll see how see ground approach and Justin immediately checks.
And look at him, tries to go for the anti-air right there, and that's where that kunai actually helps him out. Still gets to confirm on top of it, but now he's already in the corner.
Yeah, Fujimura missed the DP there, but you called it earlier, right? He went for ground approach, air approach, right? That was like immediately what he did, and Justin wasn't ready for it.
And right now, look at him. Every time, one kunai jump in the air right after.
All right, looks for the slide, takes a throw afterwards. I think that's a good choice from Justin to just recognize that Fujimura's blocking.
And now Fujimura is definitely taking his time. He knows he has a life lead, go back, reload those kunai. He knows that Justin kind of gives him space for it. So now he's looking for it. I think Justin needs to look for that too.
Yeah, you see Fujimura now slowing things down, right? Big lead, kunai release, B skill, this is it. A throw might kill here. That's gonna be it. The long range crouching medium kick still comboed into the shuriken.
Set point right now for Fujimura on this winner's side of the bracket.
Oh, he tried a crouching heavy punch, but he gets stuffed by the kunai. The meaty low, this is getting scary for Justin.
Yo, this throw pressure gets him with the shimmy, that's gonna be stunned, and man, is this trouble for Justin. Gets the neutral jump, he's still alive though.
Yep, next mix up kills here, what has he got left? Justin with the wake up jab, he activates. Just a pixel left for Justin.
He's got a long road ahead of him, ladies and gentlemen. Goes for the drill right after it. Defense holding really strong in the EX. DP, the Kazagarina taking Fujimura, moves on versus Justin Wong. who is going to be going down to that loser's side of the top eight bracket.
That sets up our winner's finals. The two most dominant players we've had this entire tournament, Gotchkun versus Fujimura.
Oh, man. Speaking of the most dominant, I mean, Fujimura, man, like I said, we just saw what it does for him to be able to control the pace of a match, especially with a character like Ibuki. And now you know time is not a factor. Mm-hmm. He can wait just as long just to close out that match, and that's what got him the W versus Justin Wong.
Yeah, exactly. That was the thing about it is, like, when he got the lead, he could play the clock, right? And when he, you know, was getting in there and getting offense going, he could do the same thing as well. So it didn't matter whether he was behind or whether he was, like, you know, in need of, like, catching up or anything. It was fine for him the whole entire time. That was a really well-played set from him in general. I think Fujimura made some good adjustments after the first game, seeing like whether Justin was able to deal with the air kunai approach, and when that became a kind of an issue, he was like, all right, I'm going to air kunai all day.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.